Welcome back to Mechanical Pros. I got Brian here, and we're gonna be talking about VRT and the Daikin VRV 4X model. Brian, tell me what VRT is and how does that make my life easier?
Yeah, I'd be glad to. So VRT, variable refrigerant temperature, is new to the VRV 4 and the VRV X. It wasn't available in previous Daikin systems. It was a set temperature. What variable refrigerant temperature is talking about is we can now determine what temperature we want our indoor coil to be. So I've got my condenser out here. I've got multiple indoor units connected going throughout the building. In the old days, your indoor coil temperature was 43 degrees, and that's what it always was. It wasn't gonna change. Now we've got a technology out with the VRV4. The default temperature is 43 degree indoor coil temperature, but now through the outdoor unit printed circuit board, I can select through a wide range of indoor temperatures. I can go as far down as setting my indoor temperature to 37 degrees. So where might this be applicable? Say maybe a design got missed. Maybe the unit's a little undersized. A couple months during the summer, you get a few complaints in this spot or that spot in the indoor. We can take it out of this mode and we can dial it down and we can go all the way down to 37 degree indoor temperature. On the flip side of that, we can go up to 52 degree indoor temperature. Maybe it's in a mild climate, doesn't get that hot, you know. Mountainous area, whatever, high is getting 70, maybe you're lucky enough to live in that type of climate, not here, but you can dial that indoor temperature up to 52 degrees. So that's gonna do a couple things. Going to keep the tenant more comfortable, which ultimately is our main goal, but it's also going to make the unit more efficient and save energy. So they call this in VRV world, four different modes you've got for variable refrigerant temp. You've got powerful, quick, mild, and eco. So powerful is immediately going to drive my indoor unit temp down to 37 degree coil. It's going to ramp these compressors up fast. They're not going to just slowly take off, just like it says powerful. They almost go wide open and they shoot for a 37 degree indoor coil temperature and they stay there until we satisfy the room temp. We can go into quick mode. We can select what our indoor coil temp we want to be in that mode, all the way from 37 to 52, but still, just like powerful, the compressors work hard to get there. Once the unit starts getting close to set point, then it's going to change in whatever indoor coil temperature is selected. That's what it's going to do. And then we've got mild, which is the default operation. 43 degree indoor coil, your compressor is going to take off and speed up nice and slow, save that energy like we want it to. Once we get close to set point on the indoor unit, we're going to start slowing our compressor down, but we're still always going to have a 43 degree coil. And then they have eco mode, again, selectable indoor coil temperatures, but just like you would think, being called eco mode, much slower operation on your compressors and your fan motors. Takes its time to get there. Once it gets there, it tries to slow down and go as slow as it possibly can to save you that energy. Again, all dependent on the climate you're in, the region of the country you're in. Maybe they've done a build out in the building since the unit was installed and now it just doesn't have quite enough it needs to in certain months of the year. Great setting to go to. You can enter all that through your field settings mode in setting mode 2 of your outdoor unit field settings.
So it sounds like it gives you a lot more flexibility.
A lot of flexibility, a lot of options. It's a great tool for the service tech, but more importantly, it's a great tool for the end user.
Yeah.
And saving energy.
That's so what we're about. You could probably tailor it for dehumidification. You can Absolutely. Probably tailor it for comfort.
Absolutely.
Quickness and response, a lot of different options. So even from an engineering standpoint, Absolutely. You missed a load by a little bit, or you're just there on the shoulder. You know, we got some flexibility now with this new, this VRT technology. So how hard is it to set up? Just go through the manual?
Easy to set yeah. up. It's all in the service manual. You can also access it through the Daikin service app. Do it all through your outdoor unit on your condenser. The tenant inside's never gonna get disturbed by you being on site. You're on the roof or on the ground, wherever your condensing unit is, you do it all from there. And trust me, you're gonna get positive reviews from that. If you've got the kind of customer you really got your arms around and you please that customer, they'll love you for setting this up because you can really critique it to your customer's needs.
Hey, Brian, tell me this. What about different modes? So would the temperature setting change in the heat mode or cooling mode? How does that work?
You can also change just those same indoor coil temperatures in the cooling mode. I can do the exact same thing in the heating mode. I'm usually about 115 degree indoor coil temperature. In the heating mode, I can also go in, change those same settings and make my indoor coil hotter in the heating mode. You can set it just for cooling to do it or just for heating to do it. Very flexible. You don't do one setting and it affects everything. You got a lot of options to choose from, whether it be heating or cooling. It's an excellent question.
That's great. Thanks, Brian. Lots of knowledge, lots of information on this new technology. Thanks for sharing it. Come back for more VRV tips and HVAC tips from Mechanical Pros. Hit that like, hit that subscribe, and we'll see you next time.